On hearing the word sponges, most people may think of the synthetic ones for washing dishes or cars. But there are also other sponges out there, mysterious living creatures. Today we will reveal all the secrets of sponges, and you will find out that they're some of the most amazing aquatic invertebrates, and so unlike others. Sea sponges were among the first animal groups to evolve on Earth. Around 600 million years ago, our planet looked like this. It's believed that there was a single supercontinent called Penotia on the planet in those times. This Lower Cambrian period marked the emergence of archaeocyathans, meaning ancient cups. When archaeocyathans died out, sponges appeared in the form in which we can see them now. Actually, over the past millions of years, many marine species are known to have vanished forever from the oceans, such as ammonites that lived in coiled shells, or orthocones with long cone-shaped shells. The trilobites, which vaguely resemble armored sea centipedes, also died out. But the sponges proved to be viable to the extent of firmly occupying niches in the aquatic fauna of the Earth even today. Early naturalists regarded the sponges as plants because of their frequently branching form and their lack of obvious movement. It was only in the 18th century that scientists found that sponges also had characteristics typical of animals. Firstly, most of them have an internal skeleton consisting of short, sharp rods called spicules. Therefore, they can be rough, prickly, and rock-hard to the touch. Such internal skeleton provides structural support and potentially defense against predators. Some sponges feel soft and springy to the touch because they have soft skeletons made of flexible fibrous spongin. Secondly, sponges cannot produce their own food like plants do. They are a variety of filter feeders, and they don't have mouths. Instead, there are tiny pores in their outer walls through which water is drawn in. Water contains bacteria and microscopic organisms. Sponges capture food with the help of special cells that have a central flagellum. Food particles adhere to the outer sticky surface of the flagellum. The filtered seawater is then expelled through the large hole at the top of the sponge. Most sponges get food by filtering water in this manner. However, in the dark depths of oceans and in marine caves there lurk carnivorous sponges. For example, the harp sponge uses narrow spines to catch small fish and tiny crustaceans. Others catch their prey with barbed hooks that cover the sponge's branching limbs. This ping-pong tree sponge may look harmless. Its entire body is covered in tiny hairs that can hook any small creature that passes by. Once prey is caught, the cells in the sponge move towards it, and digestion begins immediately. Sponges live in waters all around the world. They are abundant and thriving in all of the oceans. They also widely dwell in cold waters, including the Arctic and subantarctic areas. Recently, researchers discovered sponges beneath the Antarctic ice shelves. Even though they are mainly saltwater creatures, there are also freshwater species out there. Rivers and lakes are inhabited only by a small minority of sponges. Many people mistake these freshwater species for algae. Even in Lake Baikal, they have diversified to an extraordinary degree. Sponges are present at all water depths, with most species found in shallow waters. Quite often they are brightly colored, ranging from red and yellow to orange and violet. Deep water sponges are attached to the bottom by hollow filaments. This prevents them from sinking into soft bed sediments. Sponges living in deep waters have a more neutral color, white or translucent gray. Most sponges are damaged by direct exposure to sunlight, therefore they generally prefer caves or dark crevices. Sea sponges lack the ability to move, so most of them stay in one spot for life. It is usually solid objects, such as rocks, corals, and shipwrecks. Some sponges even attach themselves to floating debris. And this is the boring sponge, which is known for its ability to drill holes in limestone and mollusk shells. In many areas, sponges may be the dominant organisms, forming structurally complex and often highly diverse ecosystems known as sponge gardens or grounds. Often, sponges settle on wharves and bridge foundations. As for tropical areas, sponges represent one of the most conspicuous group of epibionts in mangrove prop root habitats. Sponges are generally not thought of as mobile creatures. But recently, researchers found evidence that sponges may actually be more mobile than previously thought. In fact, they do make movements, albeit limited, by expanding and contracting their bodies. Sponges are found in a wide variety of sizes. They may measure from just a few millimeters to several square meters in size. The Neptune's cup sponge is usually shaped like a wine glass and can grow to over a meter in height and diameter. And this giant barrel sponge is the largest species found in Caribbean coral reefs. Sea sponges come in many interesting shapes. There are spherical ones, such as the orange puffball sponge. Others may be cup or fan-shaped. There are many tube-like and branched species. Some are bushy or tree-like and have finger-like projections. Others are shapeless masses that form thin incrustations on objects. The form of the breadcrumb sponge is variable, depending on its environment. In areas with wave action, the surface is convoluted or flat. In sheltered areas, branched structures grow from the base. Sponges also have an amazing ability of regenerating their entire bodies, even if broken into tiny pieces. A sea sponge may be forced through a sieve and reduced to a cellular level. But if dumped into a solution, these cells will recombine into a sponge again. Furthermore, if cells of two different species are mixed, they sort themselves out and reform individuals of both separate species. Few predators pose a threat to sponges, which use three basic defense mechanisms. Their hard skeletal elements probably make them very hard to digest. Many species produce disagreeable tastes and odors that ward off predators. Others also emit toxic or noxious chemicals, which incidentally can be irritating to human skin. That's why animals hardly notice sponges, and few are those that would want to eat them. At the same time, sponges form symbiotic relationship with complex communities of organisms, which may live on the surface of the sponge or inside its canals. For example, some sponges have a symbiotic relationship with algae. The algae benefit by being protected within the sponge, and the sponge benefits from the food and oxygen produced by the algae during photosynthesis. In many cases, representatives of the macrofauna take refuge in sponges for protection from predators or for camouflage. Some crustaceans, such as crabs and specifically hermit crabs, remove a piece of a living sponge and place it on their carapace. Eventually, the piece sticks to it, acting as excellent camouflage, plus added protection from predators. The Venus flower basket is a deep ocean sponge with an unusual symbiotic relationship with a pair of crustaceans. Sometimes young male and female shrimp-like creatures enter this sponge while they're still larvae. After some time, they're unable to exit the sponge's lattice due to their size. They live in these sponges until they die. This may have influenced the adoption of the sponge as a symbol of undying love in Japan, where skeletons of these sponges are given as wedding gifts. Some bottlenose dolphins wear sea sponges like a beak glove. This protects their face from injuries and stings while they rummage for food. Now let's talk about the use of sponges. Humans have used sea sponges in everyday life since ancient times, but only species with soft, entirely fibrous skeletons have been commonly utilized. For example, the Egyptians used these sponges for embalming bodies before burial. The Romans used sponges for padding their war helmets, and early surgeons used them to clean wounds and stop bleeding. In addition, natural sponges have been used by humans for washing. Fortunately, with the emergence of numerous synthetic materials, the demand for natural sponges fell. You have probably watched SpongeBob SquarePants. Did you know that the main character was inspired by these marine dwellers? At first glance, SpongeBob looks like a kitchen sponge that has fallen into the depths of the ocean. But this is done on purpose. Animator Steven Hillenburg, who incidentally is a former marine biologist, initially drew SpongeBob as a round-shaped thing with paws, but this made the character look like a round block of cheese. Then Hillenburg changed the sketch and stylized SpongeBob as a kitchen sponge. Our story about sponges has come to an end. I hope you've learned a lot of interesting facts about these amazing animals. See you next time.